Okay, in this video we are going to prove some bound on the number of edges in a planar graph. So the first bound that we are going to prove is this one. So if G is a maximal planar graph, on n vertices where n greater than or equal to 3 and m edges, then number of edges is equal to 3n minus 6. Okay, for example, if you look at this particular graph, we can see that here this graph is not a maximal one, but we could add edges. Okay, this edge, and this edge. Okay, now we can see that if I add any more edge, then the graph will become non-planar. Okay, so if you count edge, okay, here we started with the graph with 5 vertices. So if it follows this equation, then it should have 3 times 5 minus 6 edges. Okay, 15 minus 6 is 9. Okay, so let's count the number of edges: 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Okay, so for this graph, this equation holds. Okay, so let's look at one more graph. Suppose that we started with a C5 kind of thing. Okay, so in this graph, again n equal to 5. So that says, okay, if you triangulate this one or make this a maximal planar graph by adding edges, okay, like this, and I think we could add one more edge here. Okay, I think everything is a triangle. Okay, so let's count. So again, we can see that here this m should be 9 because we have n equal to 5. Okay, so let's count the number of edges here. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Okay, so here also we saw these two graphs follow this particular equation. Okay, and the most important thing to remember is that, okay, in a maximal planar graph, every region is a triangle. Okay, so let's go and prove this statement. So in order to prove this thing, we are going to use a result that we already proved in a previous video. Okay, so we are going to use this statement that we already proved. Okay, so already proved in a previous video. So if you want to see the proof of this, okay, look at that particular video. So if G is a plane graph on n vertices and m edges in which each region is a k cycle, then the number of edges in the graph is k times n minus 2 divided by k minus 2. Okay, so we saw, okay, let's go and prove this thing using this statement. Okay, so we know if every region is surrounded by a cycle, then we have this result. So we proved in a previous video, m is going to be k times n minus 2 divided by k minus 2. Okay, and here we know in a maximal planar graph, in a maximal planar graph, each region is a triangle. Okay, each region is a triangle, or each region is a C3. Okay, so that says, okay, here if you look at this particular theorem that we proved earlier, okay, that says if G is a plane graph on n vertices and m edges in which every region is a k cycle. So in this particular situation, we have k is equal to 3, okay, since everything is a triangle. Okay, so using this equation, we get, okay, 3 times n minus 2 divided by 3 minus 2, okay, which is equal to 3n minus 6. Okay, and that's what we want to prove. Okay, so if G is a maximal planar graph on n vertices, then the number of edges is going to be 3m minus 6. Okay, so let's prove a corollary for that statement. If G is a planar graph, okay, it is not not necessary to be a maximal one. So if G is a planar graph on n vertices and m edges, then okay, this m is strictly less than or equal to 3n-6. Okay, so we can see that it follows from the previous theorem. Okay, so let me give the proof for this one. So what we could do is, since G is a planar, okay, since G is planar, it has a plane drawing. Okay, and keep adding edges to G until we get a maximal planar graph. Okay, say G dash. Okay, in this case we can see that this G dash has the same number of vertices. Okay, same number of vertices, in this case n vertices, and say m dash edges. Okay, we know that this m dash is greater than or equal to m. Okay, because this graph G dash is obtained from G by adding new edges. So that says m dash it is greater than or equal to m. Okay, and since this G dash, okay, since G dash is a maximal planar graph, okay, from the previous theorem, okay, from this theorem we know m dash is equal to, okay, so we know m dash is equal to 3n-6. Okay, but here, okay, this m dash is greater than or equal to m, or m is less than or equal to m dash, okay, and that says, okay, and since m dash is greater than or equal to m, okay, since this m dash is equal to greater than or equal to m, and we have this result m dash is equal to 3n-6, okay, we have m is less than or equal to 3n-6, okay, and that's what we want to prove. Okay, so we consider a general plane graph or planar graph with n vertices and m edges, then m is less than or equal to 3n-6. So if you look at a maximal planar graph, then we have this equality, m equal to 3n-6. Okay, so let's prove one more bound. So this this bound says something like, so if we add one more constraint, and the constraint is no triangle. So let me read out the statement. If G is a connected planar graph on n vertices and m edges with no triangles, okay, no C3, then m is less than or equal to 2n-4. Okay, so without that constraint, m is less than or equal to 3n-6. So if we add this additional constraint, okay, if this planar graph contains no triangle, then we have m less than or equal to 2n-4. Okay. So let me give a proof for this thing. Okay, it do follow from the previous theorems. Okay, so consider a plane drawing of G. Okay, so keep adding edge, okay, into this graph G, into this graph G, while keeping the resultant graph. A plane graph Okay, with not triangle. Angle. Okay, we get a graph G dash. Okay, which is maximal. Okay, which is maximal with respect to this property. Okay, take a plane drawing of this graph G and keep adding edges into G while keeping the resultant graph a plane graph with no triangle until we get G dash, okay, which is a maximal with respect to this property. Okay, it means this modified graph is also a plane graph but no triangle in this. Okay, in that sense, we obtain this G dash by adding edges, and that is going to be a maximal one kind of thing. Okay, so here we can see that if you look at, okay, for in G dash, the number of vertices, okay, number of vertices is still n. Okay, we only kept adding edges to this graph, and let, okay, in G dash the number of vertices n, and let the number of edges, okay, let the number of edges equal to say m dash. So we can very easily see, okay, we can very easily see that m dash is greater than or equal to m, because okay, here we obtain this G dash by adding edges to this graph G, okay, until we get a maximal graph with respect to that particular property. Okay, this graph is a plane graph and it do not contain a triangle. Okay, so let the regions of that graph G dash be, so it has, suppose that it has a R regions, and let the regions be say R1, R2, up to say R sub R. Okay, so be the regions in G dash. Okay, so let's consider this particular quantity. So let's consider this thing, consider a particular region, and okay, consider these regions and add all the edges, or add the number of edges on these regions. Okay, so let's consider this quantity. The number of edges on the boundary of each region. Okay, boundary of each region. Okay, so here we can see that, okay, so this is going to be greater than or equal to, so here each region is bounded by not a triangle. Okay, so it could be bounded by a C4 or a C5 or C6, etc. Okay, but it is not bounded by a C3 since it doesn't have any triangle. Okay, so that says if you sum up the number of edges on the boundary of each region Ri, okay, we can see that each boundary will be surrounded by a C4 or a C5 or C6, something like that. Okay, it won't be surrounded by a C3 kind of thing. So that says, okay, this summation will be greater than or equal to sigma I equal to 1 to R, okay, total number of regions. And this quantity will be equal to 4, and the reason is since our graph G dash has greater than or equal to 4 edges on each boundary of each region. Okay, since g dash has greater than or equal to 4 edges on the boundary of each array. Okay, so a particular region, okay, it might look something like this. Okay, the minimum thing that is possible is a C4, or it could have something like this. Okay, so it has 5 edges, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, so here that says this quantity is will be greater or equal to 4, which is the minimum kind of thing. Okay, since g dash has greater than at least 4 edges on the boundary of each region Ri. Okay, so let's look at the left hand side. The left hand side is what is nothing but the summation of all R, where, okay, this particular thing where summing is the number of edges on the boundary of each region Ri. Okay, so we can see that if you consider a particular edge, so it is on the boundary between, okay, two regions. So that says if we when we add the number of edges for Ri and this one, say Rj, we can see that this edge will get counted twice, and that is true for each and every edge. Okay, this will also get counted twice for this region and this region. Similarly, this will get counted twice for this one and this one. Okay, so that says, okay, the left hand side, this portion will be equal to 2 times the number of edges. Okay, and that says 2m is greater than or equal to 4 times. So here we are adding this 4 r times, so that is like 4r. Okay, and that implies r is less than or equal to, okay, 2 okay, so here, okay, this is not m. I think we are dealing with graph g dash. Okay, so it has m dash edges, so left hand side will be like 2 m dash. So this will be like 2 m dash greater than or equal to 4 m, and that says r will be like 2 m dash divided by 4, okay, which is equal to m dash divided by 2. Okay, so now we have an upper bound on the number of regions in m dash. And again, we can see that we started with a plane drawing of g, and we keep adding edges to this g until we get g dash. Okay, and this g dash is also a plane graph but with no triangle. So that says, okay, it do satisfy Euler's formula. Okay, so we can very easily see that g dash is a plane graph, and so it follows Euler's formula. So that says, so number of edges is same in g and g dash, n minus m dash. Okay, so we obtain g dash by adding, okay, edges. Okay, so we have that particular thing m dash, and we know that this m dash is greater than or equal to, okay, and again we can see that, okay, this m dash is greater than or equal to m, because we obtain this g dash by adding edges to our original graph g. Okay, so n minus m dash plus r, where r is the number of regions in g dash, this is equal to 2. Okay, so again we can see that is nothing but, this is nothing but 2 equal to n minus m dash plus r. Okay, so what we are going to do is we can substitute this into this equation, and that says, okay, 2 is, okay, less than or equal to n minus m dash plus m dash divided by 2. Okay, and this is nothing but n minus m dash divided by 2, and rearranging this equation we get, okay, m dash divided by 2 is Okay, if we move this to the other side, okay, you get m dash divided by 2 is less than or equal to, okay, n minus 2. Okay, and that says m dash is less than or equal to 2n minus 4. Okay, and that's what we want to prove. Okay, so proof is not yet complete. So here we want a bound on the number of edges, and since okay, we know this m dash is greater than or equal to m, okay, that implies this m is less than or equal to 2n minus 4. Okay, and that's the proof. And that says if G is a connected planar graph on n greater than or equal to 3 vertices and m edges and no triangles, okay, then m is upper bounded by this quantity, m is less than or equal to 2n minus 4. Okay, so in the next video, okay, we will apply these two theorems, okay, to prove that K5 and K3 are not planar.